Good morning, everyone. How are we doing today? It is, look, to be fair, it isn't that early in the morning, but it's early-ish. Earlier than I like to wake up. Most of the time. My 4-day weekend has just started because I am all done with like work for the week, which is real cool. And what it means is that I now have time to do a whole bunch of game design for the next 4 days. So that is what I'm gonna do with myself. And because we're friends, I'm gonna bring you along with me. Just quickly popping out chat. Here we go. All right, cool. So we are all set. I think the first thing I'm gonna do before I do anything else is just like switch over to the playbook and again just like go through and highlight everything that we need to change, and then from there we can push onwards. That is not the window we're looking at. The shaman. There we go. Cool. Alright. Yeah, so if y'all missed the announcement tweet, the shaman was the official winner of the poll, which means we are working on the shaman today. I'm very pumped about this. I have a lot of thoughts for this one. A lot that's already kind of like a lot that I'm clear on what I want and a lot of ideas that I want to execute. But also some big gaps still that I am hoping y'all can help to fill in. So, yep, ba-ba-ba. The shaman is okay, the shaman is either face primary or wild primary, and I haven't actually decided yet. And I don't think we will decide until we've got a bunch of moves and we can figure out which way they're actually leaning in practice. But like on a conceptual level, that's good to know. That's what we're aiming for. Like a combination of actual magic shit, but then also a whole bunch of like negotiation and riddling stuff based on working with spirits. All right, cool. So, whew, what to do first? Let me see. I think we might start with just going through and porting in, because I've got a whole bunch of like draft moves borrowed Mainly from another game of mine that I wrote. I'm writing. Wrote? Writing? What's the proper... What is the proper tense there? That is being worked on by me. Which is a game like in the style of Princess Mononoke and related stuff. And so obviously there's a bunch of like shamanic type animist spirit work moves in there. So I think we're just going to port a bunch of those over and then just like have a look through them and maybe think about how well they fit and what needs to be tweaked. So, brace yourselves. This is rather a lot that's about to get dropped in here. Yep. A lot of stuff. Whew. All right. Let's bring the size down. That's a start. Not really, though. All right. Oh. Okay. So, first things first, this is a dungeon world based hack. So, we don't actually need clauses for on a miss. So, I'm just going to remove all of those because we don't need them. Ah, that one's real good though. I really like that, but that's fine. Also, like, yes, apologies, chat, if you just hear nonstop the buzzing of my phone. Some, as they say, discourse is happening currently on Twitter about the definitional, like, distinction between game design and module design, and is a module a game, and is, yeah, so a lot is happening in that regard, and so, yes, my phone may be buzzing on and off as people express their opinions, just so y'all know. Come on, there we go. All right, so let's talk about this, right? So like, there's a whole like fuck ton of stuff here. Yeah, that I've just borrowed largely from my own game, a couple of bits from other games. We may steal some other bits from some other games if we feel like it in a bit. Because, yeah, as I have mentioned, this is not a project I'm working on with, like, the intention, the gung-ho intention to, like, yes, let's write a game and then sell a game. Yeah, that'd be cool. This is not, it's not a kind of project. Its main use is just going to be like for me to run this game that I have been running at home with a system that actually supports me. And then like if people on the internet, I guess, decide that they are interested in it and would like to playtest it or use it, like that's fine. And like if the demand is there, I guess, like maybe I would consider like doing a number of iterative revisions until it is like a game. But right now it's not going to be, and that gives us a lot of freedom. So, here we go. Right. This move for sure. I like that. That is a good move. I really like this move. This move is cool as fuck. This one is like a maybe, because it kind of overlaps with some other stuff. This one is very specific, because it comes from a Japanese game, right? And so, like, it very much exists within the context of like, sumo's origin as a ritualistic practice. Similarly, like, I kind of like this cook the flesh of a powerful god move, but I also don't know if it's setting appropriate. Bum 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 bum. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, so I think this one is definitely staying when you receive recite an incantation of peace and harmony. I like that. That's real cool. That's gonna be plus face. When you command a lawless spirit or little god, they're definitely having that one. Right, so like there's some of these that are very clearly like solid choices. That I'm just there's no way I'm not gonna keep them. Similarly, like when you like when you runes I don't want to use the word runes, but I also can't use the word kanji because that specifies the game. Fuck it. When you lay sacred rice paper to mark a boundary, describe who's affected, your number of words equal to your wild or less. First tested, roll plus wild. As long as the rice paper is unmarred, on 79, blah, blah, blah. Cool. Alright, so these ones, whoa, these ones can all stay, so we're gonna move them up to the top. Because we only the other thing, right, is we only need 9 moves. So like we can afford to just not pick some of these. Okay, so I really like the general shape of this move I have highlighted now. When you seek to consecrate a shrine, I feel like that's slightly too prescriptive. So like first let's just cut the miss condition because we don't need it. So when you seek to call the little gods for communion. Roll plus sincerity. On a hit, the gods. When you prepare a suitable vessel and call the little gods for communion, roll plus sincerity. On a hit, the gods are willing. And descend into the vessel. On a 10 plus, they're strong enough to answer prayers if you convince them to do so. On a 7 to 9, they have only the strength to answer questions. But first, you must persuade them. There we go. I like that one. That one's cool. I also really like this when you inscribe a tablet with prayers to your gods. Like that's a cool idea. We'll see what we do with that. I think the Carry Out the Last Rites of the Dead move is cool. I don't necessarily know if it is relevant in this game. But again, we're just gonna put it in like the maybe category. I think I've already used this move, actually. The Acolyte had that one, so that's fine. This one, similarly, I'm like, it could work, it might not. Healing rites in a sacred place of power. Roll plus sincerity. On a hit, they recover. Recover 2 wounds. Ten plus the healing leaves them. Hale and hearty, and plus is a stretch. I must take it easy for the next day. Yeah, I'm happy with that. That's fine. So how many is that? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's not bad. We only need two more. Though, like, again, this is one of those things, right? Where, like, some of these may work better as advances, right? Like, I kind of like the idea of making the. Oh god, where's my train of thought going? Yeah, I kind of like the idea of making the first one an advance instead of a move. So there's no roll, you just get to do it. But we can worry about that in a bit. Okay, so the question is now, like, there's a bunch of these that kind of like cover the same territory, right? So, sort of. Actually, fuck it, no, they don't. Actually, what the fuck am I saying? It's not true. Right? Like, the drop a geomantic chart move and the overcome by an oracular vision move are very different things. They do very distinct things. So in fact, like, I'm happy to say boom. There we go. That makes 9 moves. Done. So here's the question. What are they based on? So when you send your soul winging out on the wings of a bird, that's wild. That's face. That's face. That's wild. That's face. That one's tricky. That one's wild. That one's wild. Fuck it. You know what? The leading rights movie is actually Face. Ugh. So we got what? 1, 2. We got 4 based on Face, 4 based on Wild, and then the last one is up in the air. And actually, yeah, I don't like this as a move because actually that really should be based on Insight, and we don't want to like fuck over this playbook by making it split its resources like that. So that is going to go in here and be turned in one of those. You know what? I like this move. This is a good move. This ancestor's move. It's cool. When you light incense and call on the ancestor's rise, roll plus face. So, boom. There we go. This is now officially a playbook based on face. Start with Face plus 2, increase your face to plus 3. Nice. Yep, ba ba ba. Shaman advance. Shaman move. Alright. So there's 9 moves. Done. What next? Whole bunch of advances. And we need 9 of them. Prum, 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 prum. I think, okay. What is cool here? What works? When So, okay, Shaman advances. An advance that gives you a little god as a follower, spirit taming type stuff. An advance that means that pacts you make with spirits are binding. To both of you, in case that's not clear. I also think it's worth thinking about what's like the base shaman move, right? Like, what do you get for free? Like, what is of these moves, like, what are the most quintessentially like about the class? I would argue they have to be, it has to be, whatever it is, it has to be a move that is based on face. Because that's what the class's core stat is. So that, like, I think that's inescapable, right? No, it's not the healing rites. It's maybe. Called the little gods for communion, maybe. I don't want it to be the command one. I think that one you have to buy. Depending on what your style wants to be. So yeah, maybe it's this one, right? It's like, what are we going to call that move? That's called Speaker with Spirits. Called Spirits or Lesser Beast Gods for Communion. Yep. So you start with Speaker with Spirits. Move with your background and 2 other moves or advances of your choice. So actually, that's not an advance. That is again a starting move. So I think you start with both of those, and that's going to be called. Tails. Stories or folklore. this if it is or not. Fuck it, we're gonna call it roll plus face. And just like deal with it. So you start with Spooky with Spirits, 10,000 tails, a move from your background, and one other move or advance of your choice. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're still one move short now, but we can worry about that in a little bit. Yeah, so an advance, and I think you can take this one like 3 times or something, right? Like, I think that's just a thing. Bum 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 bum. I think the last rites move is for the priest background, because that's one of the backgrounds for the shaman, right? So, like, they're, yeah, if I go down here, like priest. Wanderer. And, outsider. Yeah, and I think the priest move is the burial move, right? Like, it's like, you can bury people, because you're great at stuff. So 9. Alright. Oh. Why is formatting so difficult? I often wonder. But that's fine. Alright, cool. That's good. That's solid. Oh. Oh. Whoops. Whoops. We made a bit of a mistake there. That's a very long move. Unite them as an ancestor. To give future counsel, you speed their soul to its fate. You set obstacles. Another option, but spelled properly. Why are we suddenly in symbol? That's so weird. Another option. It is true until the world's end. Ending of 79 is true. That is long, so long as the grave remains remains sanctified. And that could mean a bunch of things, right? Like, that could mean, oh, you all stopped going to the grave, and no one has worshipped there in 100 years, and now it's fucked. Or it could mean some horrible necromancer has come and defiled the grave of your friend, and now your friend's ghost is in torment, or some shit, right? Like, all kinds of possibilities there. All kinds of fun possibilities. You speed them, their soul to its fate. Without obstacle. There we go. That's better. That's better. There we go. There we go. Alright. Okay, so we're now happy with this. Good job, team. If we just steal these little doodaddy things. What's that needs still Caramond.
There we go.
Actually, those need to be black dots, but that's fine. We can fix that in a bit. We're going to call that Soul's Flight. Song of Peace. Peaceably marks XP while they hear your voice. There we go, the Song of Peace. This is like spirit, like tamer of spirits, or lesser beast god. Cool. There we go. It's called Sacred Wards. Healer. Use the hearty. Leaves them strong on 10 plus. Yep. Future sight. I really want to call it Speaker for the Dead. I do. I know Orson Scott Card is like a trash person, right? But like, when I read Ender's Game for the first time, when I was very young and didn't know any better, it did make quite an impression on me, and I really do want to call it Speaker for the Dead, but I'm not going to. I'm going to call it like Heed the Dead. So, let's just quickly reorder these two, just because it's a good thing to do. And then we want Healer, and then we want Heed the Dead. Oh, okay. Oh, what the? Happened just now. We got Healer, we got Heed the Dead. What the? Is it justified? It's justified. It's the issue. Call this like God Sight or something. Oh, just because I can. There we go. So that actually goes in slightly earlier. My God, can we just. Can we just take all of this and just properly center it? That's much better. So, God's Sight, Healer, Heed the Dead. then Soul Slight, then Tamer of Spirits. Cool. Awesome. Boom. Done. So that's all of the Shaman Knee moves that we need. So yeah, now it becomes a question of advances, right? So, yeah, there's like, if we get the little thing again, it's Spirit. Not familiar. Bound. We're gonna call that voice of command. This is called Spirit Tamer. And you can take it three times. This is called Oathbound. Because that's a cool name for a thing. It means we still need five more. I like the idea of like spirit. Okay, I don't know what I want to call this. It's like that trope. Of like, oh, sorry. Of someone, right, who's like used magic and pacts with spirits to like bind themselves to be safe from various kinds of harm. Right, like it's a thing. No examples are coming to mind right now, right? But like that mythic trope where it's like, I can't be hurt by this, I can't be hurt by that. Like, I'm layered with, like, taboos and protections and oaths that keep me from dying in certain ways. I don't remember his name, but the nephew of Gwydion dies that way in the Blodgewood myth. And there's certainly others. So we call it, like, Armored by Faith is not a good name for it. Oh, fuck, you know what I'm thinking of. You know, I've just remembered, right? It's like, it's the bit in Norse mythology, right? Where Freya goes around and, like, makes all everything on Earth promise never to hurt Balder. And everyone does, except the mistletoe. And then, you know, obviously because of Loki it all goes wrong. But, like, it's that thing, right? Pact armor. An advance where you pick a type of thing and it doesn't hurt you anymore. Cause that sounds like a cool thing to be able to have. Have we used the word speaker yet? We've got speaker with spirits. I want one that's like voice of the wilds. When you speak on matters on matters of the spirits, the beast gods, the wild magic, or the wild magic, none can deny the truth of your words. None can deny your everyone accepts your authority and the truth of your words. They may publicly deny these, But in their heart, they know the truth. Your authority and, yeah, like your truthfulness. Matters it yet? Spirits of spirits, beast, gods, or wild magic. Everyone accepts your authority and your expertise. There we go. They may publicly deny them, but in their hearts, they know the truth. That takes us up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, wait. Two more advances. Bum, 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 bum. Let me have a look back over and see. Is there anything here that I've missed, that I have had written down about it in the past? There is not. Like, what else should the shaman be able to do? What is a cool fictional position thing? Oh, you know what it is. You know what it is. I've got it. It's like called like Between Worlds. You can touch and interact with spirits and magic as though they were solid physical objects. You can always touch and interact with spirits and magic as though they were for solid physical objects. You can block magic like you would a sword, seize and grapple incorporeal spirits and similar. Would any weapon like you could any weapon. Yeah, that's cool. That's a cool thing that they can do. This is if sorry, yeah, to make like a Blades in the Dark reference, right? Like this is your fuck, what's it called? Spirit Fighter? This is that cutter move that lets you like punch spirits in the face, and it works. This is that move. But for spirits and shit, I guess. Yep. Okay, so you have made pacts with a certain with a certain kind of your oaths with certain spirits keep you from specific sources of harm. When you take this advance, when you take this advance, choose a kind of harm, fire, poison, stabbing, that you are protected against. Never take the harm, whenever you make, not take, whenever you make the harm moves from this kind of harm, you only choose, you and the GM can only choose from pain, never from wounds. Which means it can hurt you, but you can't die. Which in certain circumstances could be really bad and fucked up, right? Like, you might regret taking that one, in certain circumstances. not when you take each time you take this advance, choose a chain of harm. Yep, cool. Oathbound. Whenever.